All right, welcome everybody. We're happy you are here with us for our very first Flipside Camp. We are here today to do Adventures Through Time with Shelley Clayburn, and we're going to focus on dinosaurs today and some fun activities with that. A few housekeeping things before we get started. My name is Renee Ford. I'm the Education Coordinator for Bright Lights, and I will be your host. I'm also joined by my friends Casey and Lori, and they're going to be helping out. Say hi, guys. Hello. They're waving. I realize you may be looking at this and thinking, I can't see myself and I can't talk. Well, we're doing this in a webinar format. So that means that you can see us and you can hear us, but we cannot see your pictures, which I wish we could. There's like 70 of you out there, which is super exciting. We're glad that you're here. But you can still ask questions and you can still communicate with us. There is a function at the bottom of your screen called the Q&A, which is where you can click on it and type your questions for us. So between Casey and Lori and myself, we will either ask Shelley those questions, or we'll wait for a good moment to hop in and see if we can share those. So please don't hesitate to type those in there, and we will get to you as quickly as we can. I also want to let you know that we are recording the session, and it will be on our YouTube channel. We will share that URL later on in the chat function. But if you want to go back later, tomorrow, the next day, you want to do the activities again, you'll be able to do that. And also, you'll we'll be able to have people watch who weren't able to join us today. So with that, we're going to go ahead and get started, and I'm going to turn this over to Shelley because she is going to give us some good information about dinosaurs, and I think she might have a joke or two to share with us too. So Shelley, take it away.
Hi Renee, thank you so much. And yes, I'm going to start out with some jokes. My name is Shelley, and you can see I'm surrounded by some of my favorite things. We're going to talk about that today. But first off, some jokes. I have this great book. I know it looks backwards to you, doesn't it? Or does it? I don't know, yell at me. It says dinosaur jokes, and I found some of my favorite jokes, all right? So here's one of them. You're just gonna have to yell, or you can chat the answer. What's the best way to talk to a T-Rex? The best way to talk to a T-Rex. Long distance. Long distance. How about this one? What was T-Rex's favorite number? 1, 2, 8. Yeah, Connor got it. Connor Wade got it. 8, like 8 and 8. What has a spiked tail, plates on its back, and 16 wheels? Spiked tail, plates on its back, and 16 wheels. A stegosaurus on roller skates. I saw a stegosaurus there. Good job. So, like Renee said, my name is Shelley, and during regular Bright Lights, I teach a class called Adventures Through Time. And on Adventures Through Time, we talk about the Magic Treehouse series. And so hands up, how many of you have read some of the Magic Treehouse series books? A lot of hands. Today we're gonna do Dinosaurs Before Dark, sort of. I'm not gonna able to read this whole book to you, but I know that if you're in kindergarten or first or second grade, you can probably read this yourself or have someone read it to you. This week, we're going to take a look at some of the other ones. We're going to take a look at The Night at Dawn. We're going to take a look at Mummies in the Morning. And we're going to take a look at Pirates Past Noon. But today, we're going to focus on the dinosaur one for I Dig Dinosaurs. In the Magic Treehouse story, so there's Jack and Annie. And Jack loves books. And Annie loves adventure. And so they come across this magic treehouse in the woods near their house. And they climb up into the treehouse. and they go on this adventure. And every time Jack picks up a book, like he picks up a dinosaur book, and he says, oh, I'd like to go there, and it whisks them off. Now, someone just said there's a Merlin series. There is. There's some Camelot. And so if you love adventures and you love books that have kind of the same characters to follow, you would love the Jack and Annie Treehouse stories. So I'm going to read a story to you. We're going to kind of go back and forth today. We have some crafts to do. We have some books to share. We have some fiction. We have some nonfiction. And so this is a fiction book called How Do Dinosaurs Stay Friends? How Do Dinosaurs Stay Friends? Now, on the inside, I'll zoom it. You see all these dinosaurs that are going to be in the book, and all of them have these crazy names because there are so many dinosaurs. And a little bit later, my friend Lori, we're hopefully going to have a poll where you are going to choose from your favorite 10 dinosaurs. I mean, there's so many. We couldn't put all of them on the poll, but we chose 10, and we're going to ask you a little bit later to see if you can answer the poll as to your favorite dinosaur. So this is fiction. How do dinosaurs stay friends, obviously. And it says, how does a dinosaur keep his best friend when a terrible fight might signal the end? Does he scribble a note with a horrible scowl? Does he wipe muddy feet on his friend's favorite towel? Here it is. Does he tear up a book that his friend let him take? A very good way to make friends. Does he throw his friend's lunchbox straight in the lake? Does he write on the blackboard a very bad name? Dinos D-long is stupid. Does he tell the kids that his friend is to blame? Does he kick his friend's bike? Does he egg his friend's door? No, I hope not. Does he push his friend so hard he lands on the floor? Does he scream? Is he mean? Does he spit? Does he spy? Does he tell the new teacher a very big lie about who did the pushing and why? No, a dinosaur doesn't. He won't even try. He sends a nice note, taking most of the blame. He's surprised when he finds that his friend did the same. He has his friend over to share and to play, letting him choose his first toys on that day. He brings to the school a toy dragon and knight with a card that says, really, I don't want to fight. And then, when the class is all given a break, he gives his friends cookies he helped his mom make. He wraps up a favorite bear with a bow, and he brings it along as a gift just to show that even though friends may occasionally fight, there is always a way to make everything right. Good friends, good hugs and more keep a friend dinosaur. How do dinosaurs stay friends? Now, Lori has a poll that she's
Shelley, I have a poll, but it'll be a little bit here. And the computer bug is mad.
I tell you, that happens. So later, Lori's going to do a poll, and she's going to chime in when she's ready. And I want you to know that sometimes technology works great, and sometimes technology doesn't. And when you were a remote learner for your school, you probably saw that on some of your Zooms with your teachers, that sometimes things go well and sometimes not. And that's kind of the fun of technology. So when the poll is ready and you're going to take it, if it works for you, great. If it doesn't work for you, just know that that's okay too. You can shout out your answers or you can send it in the chat. So Lori will let us know when she's ready for that. Let's talk about dinosaurs. Okay. Dinosaurs happened 225 million years ago, and they're reptiles. They have waterproof, scaly skin, and young that hatches from eggs. And for the next 160 million years, they ruled the Earth. And some were huge, and some were the size of dogs. And they roamed until they became extinct. And there's all kinds of theories as to what happened to the dinosaurs. There were meat eaters, carnivores. There were plant eaters, herbivores. But there were 30 times more herbivores than carnivores. Now, when we think about the size of dinosaurs, we just said that some are huge and some were tiny, like dogs almost. And so I'm gonna turn the screen. So hopefully you can see this. And I'm gonna drop this down just a little bit. All right. So this would be the footprint for a T-Rex. And it's on a piece of chart paper. And you all have seen chart paper at your schools probably. So maybe you're thinking, that's not so big. And you're right. T-Rex is about 3.3 feet by 1.5 feet. Oh, there's Daxie. There's my cat. Daxie says, hi. Live TV. You can see that I have some vocabulary here. I have paleontologist and footprint and skull and claw and bone. And a T-Rex walked on his tippy toes. So now I'm going to show you. Bye, Daxie. I'm going to slide this up. I'm going to show you the size of a T-Rex tooth. Okay. And all right, here's my hand. So when you hold up your hand, you can kind of see how big your hand is. And that's the size of a T-Rex tooth. So we're going to take another look at how big some of the dinosaurs were. And I'm going to have Renee switch us over to the craft table. Renee, can you do that for us?
I am going to do that right now, she says with lots of confidence, because that's what you do with technology. Right, everybody?
That's right.
Let's see if I went to the right place. Well, what are y'all seeing right now?
We still
see the piano. Hold on. I can do better. We're at the right table.
There it is.
Success is good.
Yeah. Thank you, Renee.
You're welcome.
So this is a story called How Big Were Dinosaurs? Because I just showed you that T-Rex tooth and that footprint of a T-Rex. So this was a book that I found that asked how big were dinosaurs? And it says, stalking, running, stomping, crushing. When we think of dinosaurs, we think of huge monsters. But how big were dinosaurs really? So this is one, is this not crazy? Microraptor was a deadly hunter, but he would barely be able to look a modern day chicken in the eye. The truth is, dinosaurs came in all shapes and sizes. Protoceratops had very large skulls and heavy beaks for ripping tough plants. They were strong and built for defense, but no bigger than a baby rhinoceros. And honestly, with a name like, you might need to help me. You can point to the screens to help me sound this out. Lialinosaurus. I need to hear from some of those dinosaur specialists out there. You'd think these dinosaurs were tree-eating giants. But look at this. They stood only 2 feet tall. They lived through the cold, dark winters near the South Pole, where emperor penguins live today. Even Velociraptor, which we've seen a lot in a lot of movies, a dinosaur that fills our imagination with its flesh-ripping claws and powerful jaws, was the size of a dog. This one, look at this. Struthiomimus, were the perfect size for going to races. With slender legs and long tails, they were built like a very light horse and ran just as fast, up to 35 miles an hour. Ankylosaurus, this is a common one that a lot of you have seen maybe, was a little taller than an SUV but weighed 4 times as much. Built to withstand attack, they were covered in armored plates and sharp spikes, and they had a great bony club for a tail. Imagine being stuck in traffic jam with the cranky Ankylosaurus. Stegosaurus. Okay, there's the cows. So it says that the Stegosaurus weighed as much as 3 cows, but with bony plates on his back that could be up to 3 feet long. He looked much bigger. Bigger isn't always smarter. This giant plant eater had this brain the size of a walnut. So about the size of a walnut. Like a giant unicorn, look at this. Probably a silent T, probably Centaurus. Had a strange spike growing out of its skull. We don't know what this spike was used for, but with a dinosaur-sized appetite and hundreds of teeth, he could have gobbled your garden in a few quick bites. Thank goodness he was just a plant eater. Taurosaurus had a 10-foot skull and horns that grew as tall as a first grader. So some of you first graders out there, you wouldn't want to make this dinosaur do something he didn't want to do, like go to the veterinarian. Oh, this is crazy. Therizinosaurus had claws that grew up to 36 inches, longer than a man's arm. But don't worry, these plant eaters most likely use their claws to strip bark off trees and pull down branches. Oh, and then we've got the Tyrannosaurus Rex. And I just showed you that tooth, so you can see kind of in comparison. Tyrannosaurus Rex had a skull nearly as long as a man is tall. He had strong jaw muscles that could crunch down 10 times the force of an alligator bite. Imagine cleaning the 9-inch long teeth of this fearsome meat eater. But even the fierce Tyrannosaurus Rex was no match for the biggest, most enormous, colossal giant of them all. Argentinosaurus. As long as 4 school buses, this dinosaur was probably the biggest animal ever to walk on land. A full-grown adult weighed more than a herd of 17 elephants. And Argentinus was an incredibly 45,000 times bigger than Microraptor. But the largest dinosaur was only dangerous if you were a tree. Argentinosaurus must have eaten them by the ton. Dinosaurs really did come in every size, the smallest birds, bigger than herds, and in between. And then it goes on to talk about how we know how big dinosaurs are because of their fossils. Now, one thing we don't know about dinosaurs are the colors of dinosaurs. So we're gonna do a little craft, and this is going to be a little dinosaur mask. And on the Bright Lights website, there were some handouts that you could print out and enjoy later or while we're doing this today. And I'm just going to show you how you can make your very own dinosaur mask. So, yeah, I'm on my supplies here. My supplies, I need a paper plate, and I need some glue. I got some markers. All right, maybe some paint. Of course, scissors, right? That's, I guess, a straw or something to make my handle. So when I put it up in my eyes, that you can see it, I'll show you back over to the piano table over there in just a minute. So that's what you need. Now, some of you might have paint today, and some of you might not have paint. I painted this one ahead of time. So I took my paper plate, and I just decided that I was going to cut it about halfway, and I could make it swirly, or I could make it straight. Woo! All right, however I want to make it like that. Okay, so that's, and then I painted this one. I also could just grab some markers, because we have no idea the colors of dinosaurs, really. Paleontologists believe that they're probably similar colors to the reptiles that we have around today. So on the Bright Lights website, I've given you this little printout, but I know, I can tell by all of your chats that you're very crafty people. This is going to be the horns. Now, I had a friend that told me they looked more like ears, so we might have to make those a little sharper. This is part of the snout, and this is part of the snout as well. You can see that. Okay. So I've got my top of my mask painted or colored, marker, whatever you want to do. I've got my horns and my snout and my other snout, and I've cut it out. And this is kind of the nose. All right, and this is kind of the bottom part. I would glue that on. And I am kind of a cheater when it comes to crafts, because sometimes glue works really, really well. And sometimes I might just want to staple it. Whoops, trading. Now, I had some friends that told me that I needed to make these horns a little sharper. Do you agree? So, because I think you're going to have to decide what your dinosaur is. But this is, for me, I'm thinking Stegosaurus. I'm going to glue this. I do a little singing while I craft.
Shelley, this is Lori, and if someone didn't have a paper plate, they could probably use just a piece of cardboard or cardstock or something like that, right?
Definitely, definitely. Just anything, because the shape doesn't really matter. And this was just cardstock or construction paper, but a lot of these things are just things I think, I hope, that you could find around your house. So you can see on my other one, I added some spots and I added some stripes. It's a little tigerish maybe. Okay, so you can do whatever you want. So I can draw circles or, now I drew a little nostrils. This almost looks like Daxy the cat. Now this is the part, all right, that you probably want to have a parent or an older brother or sister do, because you need to give it some eyes. And I can use scissors. I also sometimes can start a little hole with a pin, all right, for eye holes. And then once you get that little hole started, remember, have an adult help you probably. Then you're going to make the little eye holes. I don't know why I went with green. A pink dinosaur would be cool, I think. Really any color. So there's my holes. Now I could go on and decorate and decorate. I used, on my original one that I showed you to start, I used a straw. So it's kind of almost like a Mardi Gras mask. So I can hold that up and peek at you and have a dinosaur mask. What do you think?
Okay. I think that looks awesome, Shelley. I bet there's, we've had lots of people talking about how they are working alongside you. They could probably even do these in, I don't know, you could put on a play or something with them.
I think so too. So if you're doing it with me, that is excellent. If you didn't, if you don't have the materials yet, that's okay too. This is Nebraska, so sometime today, sometime this week, there's probably going to be a rainstorm. And so this could be a rainy day activity. All right. Looks like someone asked what our favorite dinosaurs were. I think my favorite dinosaur is Brontosaurus. I'm not sure why, but I like it.
Lori, I don't know.
Ready for that?
Sorry, go ahead. Lori, do you know yours?
Oh, gosh, I've got so many favorites, but I like, I'm kind of old school. I like a T-Rex, but yeah, my new favorite is the Velociraptor.
Nice. Very, very nice. Lori, is that poll going to be able to happen or not?
I just don't think it's going to happen. It's just mad at me, I guess.
That is okay. Remember I said in the beginning, I always tell my fifth graders during the year, and during remote learning, I have said to them, there's no tears in remote learning. There's no tears when it comes to Now, I'm going to share my screen because we're going to do an I'd rather. And here it comes. Can you see that, everybody?
This, I see it. Anybody?
Right.
Guys, are you on the, yes, we got yeses. Oh, we have yeses, fantastic.
Yes. So a lot of you know how to do a would you rather. And so in your chat, you're going to answer the would you rather with either A or B. So would you rather be a carnivore or an herbivore? Would you rather? And what are most people wanting to be?
Oh, we have, gosh, we have a lot of people. We got probably more carnivores, I would say right now, than herbivores. And I have to say, I would probably go for carnivore too.
Carnivore, you're a meat eater.
That's right. I think so, yeah.
All right, how about this one? Would you rather be able to fly like a pterodactyl or be able to swim like a Spinosaurus? Would you rather?
Well, it...
A lot of flying.
I think. But probably because we're all ready to just go somewhere, right? Flying sounds like a nice option.
They're all ready to fly somewhere. How about this? Would you rather be the paleontologist, the person that studies all those dinosaurs, or would you rather just be the dinosaur?
Oh, boy, this one's kind of mixed.
Is it?
Yeah, a little bit.
A little split.
There's probably pros and cons to both, right?
There might be. A paleontologist would be really, really cool, especially if you got to name a dinosaur. How about this? Would you rather read a funny book about dinosaurs, or would you rather read a dinosaur field guide, a nonfiction that gives you dinosaur facts?
Again, we've got splits. We got, I think, a lot of people are liking the field guide, But then I saw some out there that wanted the funny one. Got some nonfiction. That was a good way to describe what that'd be.
It seems like my fifth graders often go with the nonfiction. So I think we sometimes change what we like to read as we turn ages. I know I have. How about this? Would you rather have a dinosaur as a pet or a dog?
Oh, I bet you can guess what these answers are going to be.
Yeah, I think dinosaur.
I think there's a lot of people that think a dinosaur would be fun. Now, I don't know where you keep your dinosaur, but...
You could.
We also have a lot of dog lovers.
Dinosaur's teeth.
How about, let's see, next one. Oops. Would you rather swim with whales or swim with dinosaurs? I love dinosaurs, but I think I would go with the whales.
Yeah, we got a lot of whales.
A lot of whales.
We all want to fly somewhere to swim with whales.
Would you rather have the teeth of a T-Rex or the armor of an Ankylosaurus? I know it says armor of Ankylosaurus up at the top, but that doesn't mean that that's what you have to be.
Well, I don't know. We got a lot of people coming in with the teeth. What are you seeing there, Lori?
Yeah, I'm seeing a lot of teeth. That's a theme.
Kind of like what superhero power you might want to have. Would you rather play hide and seek with a dino or tag with a dino? I don't know. Maybe it's kind of the same thing.
I'm laughing because I'm thinking, where would a dinosaur hide? I mean, with all the different sizes, I suppose there's some that could hide pretty easily. Right? We got a lot of people that are, Addie just said neither. She might actually be on the right track.
That's right. Jack and Annie, they play kind of a hide and seek game with a dinosaur. Would you rather have a pet dino that could talk? Or would you have a pet dino that could dance?
Ooh, we have a lot of talking.
A lot of talking.
We want to talk. Imagine those conversations that you could have.
Oh, yeah. I wonder what their voice would sound like.
I don't know. Loud. Loud. Now, I have this last I'd rather because I think, fingers crossed, Casey, are we going to be able to do a Go Noodle?
We're going to try it.
Okay. So everybody, you've been sitting for quite a while. You've been sitting for about 30 minutes. So I need you all to get up and get ready while Casey puts on Dinosaur Stomp.
All righty. Hopefully you can see it. Here we go.
Stegosaurus, call me a brontosaurus. I'll get you with my taurus. Hey, 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 hey. Way down Jurassic Park, hanging out after dark. I'm scary like a shark. Hey, 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 hey. I hang with Littlefoot. He gives me great input. We dance at Pizza Hut. Hey, hey, hey.
T-Rex, smashing all your objects. I'll put you in a hex. Hey, 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 hey. I'm in the jungle roaring, but when it gets real boring, I go a carnivore. And hey, 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 hey. Velociraptor name, eating meat is my game. Extinction I became. Hey, 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 hey. There goes a pterodactyl. Nothing rhymes pterodactyl. I just love pterodactyl. Hey, 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 hey.
Well, if that didn't get people moving, I don't know what is. Plus, you are going to have that song in your head all day.
I'm a little sweaty now. All right. We're back at the craft table. Thank you for doing that Zoom, or for that Go Noodle. We're back at the craft table, and I have one other really simple craft that you can make with things that I think you might have around your house. So for this one, to make these little silly dinosaurs, you need some egg cartons. And I know that there's two different kinds of egg cartons. There's this paper one, and then there's that slip one. The slip one you can probably use too, as long as you have maybe some markers that are permanent markers. So I have those, fell over. And I have need some markers, and I need some pipe cleaners. And once again, I need some craft paint. But sometimes craft paint just isn't something that you have around your house. And so if you do have markers, this one I just made with markers, and I'm into polka dot dinosaurs, I guess. So this is a part that you might need help with. You're going to cut your egg carton apart. And it's a little tricky. And I know that you all have great imaginations because you're readers. And so this is one of those crafts that you have to sort of squint with your imagination, but I know you all have it. So I cut apart my egg carton, and earlier I painted, I have a yellow one, I have a pink one, and of course my green. And I also have my polka dots here. So once I decorated it with paint or markers, I've gotten my bag of googly eyes out, and I'm just going to glue a couple googly eyes on each dinosaur. And so this one, I glued them on. They're a little cross-eyed. Love this. And for this one, I've taken my pipe cleaner, and I poked a little hole here and a little hole here. So once again, you might need some help. And I just put my pipe cleaner through the first hole, and I kind of wadded it up inside so it doesn't fall out. And I decided that this is a Stegosaurus. So I made it kind of zigzaggy, and I put it in this back one. But then I got to thinking, well, I like that. But could I make a flying dinosaur? And so that's what I'm doing with this one. I'm gonna put a hole on the side. Watch your fingers get help with that. I'm gonna put my pipe cleaner in the hole, both sides. I'm gonna come around and wiggle this pipe cleaner together so his wings won't fall out. Let's tuck it all up in there. And then I can make my dinosaur wings. What do you think? That's kind of silly. Almost looks like a bat. But those are mine. I can make a whole collection. Since egg cartons have 12, a dozen, I could make 12 of these fun little dinosaurs.
friends. You could write a story about them. There's all sorts of adventures your egg carton dinos could go on. Shelley, question for you. If you don't have an egg carton at home, I was trying to think what would be something similar that might give that shape. Any ideas? I suppose you could take construction paper and kind of bend it. I don't know. What do you think?
I see.
What about a Dixie cup?
Oh, yeah.
A Dixie cup.
You could do a small cup, something with some structure there. That's a good one.
All right. Now, I told Renee we were going to go back to the book, but I think we're going to stay here because I think that I want to show you this one up close. It's a little easier. This was one of my boys' favorite dinosaur books. I'm going to show it to you really quickly because we're almost out of time. But when I open it up like this, I see Tyrannosaurus Rex, which Lori said was her favorite dinosaur. And there's Stegosaurus, which I know is a lot of your favorite dinosaurs. Okay. But with my mix-up dinosaur book, I can do this. And now I have created my own dinosaur, an Iguaxacephalus.
I love that it gives you the names too. That's some of the hardest things, right? Is to make up the name.
I changed the tail. Galsacephalus. Let's get rid of this middle part here. Oh. Oh yeah. Galsacephalus. I can see, I remember why my boys like this book so much. Galsacephalus. Let's give it a different head. What do you think? That is great. Now, on the Bright Lights website, I have sent this page to you, and it's called My Dinosaur, Design Your Own Dinosaur. So I want you to think about what your own dinosaur would look like, and sometime this week, maybe you could draw your own dinosaur later today. And it's My Dinosaur's Name Is, My Dinosaur Likes, My Dinosaur Doesn't Like. So maybe, like this crazy book, you can create your crazy dinosaurs. Or maybe your dinosaur is one that we know. But maybe not. Maybe you can be a paleontologist and come up with that. All right, Renee, can we head over to the book now?
We absolutely can. I think. Book Nook. All right. All right. Look, there you are. Oh, and you've got your mask too. That's awesome.
There's my mask. So I so wish I could see you with all of your masks. There's my little eye holes there. Perfect. I hope you enjoy and make a great mask. Now, we're almost finishing up here, but I want to show you something else that's also on the Bright Lights website. And that's a sheet that looks like this. And it says, I Spy Dinosaurs. And there's two sheets. And this one, I have the answers on the back, asks you to look for Tyrannosaurus Rex, Stegosaurus, dinosaur eggs, dinosaur footprints, Brontosaurus, and a pterodactyl. And so, it's an I Spy. I tell you, I keep on counting these and I keep on getting different numbers for the Brontosaurus. So I hope you do that. And I wish there was a way for you to let me know how many there were because I keep re-adding.
Well, so we could always, Shelley, we could always have, if the kids want to ask their parents to go to the Bright Lights Facebook page, they could always post there. That's maybe an option.
That would be perfect.
Yeah, because, so we can.
Yeah, because I keep on counting, and you can see from my sticky note, my scratches, that I keep on counting, and I get something different every time. So I'm asking.
We can get a lot of people to do it. We'll see what our common number is.
Our last book is called 10 Terrible Dinosaurs by Paul Strickland, and it's a rhyming book we're going to end with today, and then we're going to talk about tomorrow. 10 Terrible Dinosaurs Standing in a Line. soon began to push and shove until there were, shout it out, nine enormous dinosaurs. Their dancing was just great. But one was much too spiky. So then there were eight. Sorry, your nose. Eight elated dinosaurs who thought they were in heaven. But one nearly popped. So then there was seven. Seven silly dinosaurs playing goofy tricks. But one went too far, so now there were six. Six stomping dinosaurs who danced a crazy jive. But one got tangled up, so now there were five. Five feisty dinosaurs stamping on the floor, kind of like what you did with Dinosaur Stomp. Quiet down, cried someone's mom. And then there were four.
They're shouting them out, Shelley, just so they're they're listening. Yep, they're playing along.
Four fearless dinosaurs swinging from a tree. The one got stuck, you know it. So then there were three thundering dinosaurs who flapped and almost flew. One took off, so there were, count them, two. Two feisty dinosaurs tired of all the fun. Sorry. One got taken home, so now there was one. One weary dinosaur who soon began to snore. His friends sneaked up behind him and suddenly yelled, roar. Back to Tim. Tomorrow, let me grab something, hold on. I've got something that we're gonna use tomorrow, because tomorrow we're going to take a look at hieroglyphs and hamsters. And so before I pass this back to Renee to finish up for our day, I want you to watch this. Ready? You gotta listen. Can you do that? Because that's what we're gonna do tomorrow. We're gonna dance. Betsy's looking. Yep. Oh, Liam doesn't like that, but Liam, I sure do. It's one of my favorite things. So tomorrow we're going to take a look at ancient Egypt, and we're going to learn about hieroglyphs and how to write your name in hieroglyphs. We're going to make a headdress for ourselves with a cobra. And so if you want to check out the Bright Lights website and look at the sheets that we're going to be using for tomorrow, so you would be ready for that, that would be absolutely great. All right. So I hope you had a little fun today, gave you something to do on a Monday morning. And I'm hoping that I see a bunch of you tomorrow. All right. Back to you, Renee.
All right. Thank you, Shelley. That was so much fun. I hope we had a lot of people join us today. Remember that we'll be back tomorrow, just like Miss Shelley said. We will also post where the video is going to be on our YouTube channel. If we don't get that in the chat, we'll put it on our Facebook page. Nope, it's right there. Look, Miss Casey is just on top of it. So if you guys want to go back and watch parts of this, you want to do the craft again, you'll be able to do that by going there. And then we'll be back tomorrow at 10. And we're going to have more fun. So thank you, everybody. Have a great rest of your day.
Bye, all. Thank you.